Hello students of class 5. So today I am going to discuss some more application of decimals. Okay, where we can apply this, where decimal numbers is used. Okay, so first of all see, the one method is there that is called unitary method. I am going to discuss that method in this lecture. Okay, unitary method. So for unitary method, I am going to give you one example first. Suppose whenever you went to market and you want to buy some objects or some items, okay, then you must know the cost of one item. Okay, if you know the cost of one item, you can easily able to find the cost of many items. Okay, suppose you want to buy 10 chocolates, so you must know the cost of one chocolate. Okay, so in that case, you know, if you know cost of one chocolate, by multiplying that cost with the quantity which you want to buy, okay, by multiplying with the quantity that is 10, so you can easily able to find the cost of 10 chocolates. Okay, so so that means finally the conclusion is that we must know the cost of one item. Okay, so previously also in multiplication chapter I already discussed that part, that if we know the cost of one thing, then we can easily able to find the cost of many. Similarly, if cost of many items is given and we want to find the cost of one item, then also we can find using the operation division. Okay, because using division, the number will become smaller than the original number. We know that. Okay, if you divide a larger quantity by a smaller quantity, say 2, okay, suppose I am multiplying 100 by 2, then I will get 50. So 50 is smaller than 100. So we know that after dividing a particular quantity, the final answer will become smaller than the previous one. Okay, so division, where we use division, whenever we want to find the cost of one item. Okay, so see here, cost of one item, or you can say if you are dividing a piece of ribbon, suppose there is a ribbon having length 8 cm and you want to cut it into equal pieces, 8 equal pieces, okay, you want to cut it into 8 equal pieces. So then in that case also we can easily use division to find the length of one piece. Okay, so in that case also we can use division. So here see, one example I am giving you. So this is the cost, okay, cost of 5 kg wheat flour. So cost of 5 kg wheat flour is given rupees 36.50. so see, this is a decimal number, the whole part of this decimal number is 36 and this is in rupees. Similarly, in the decimal part it is having paise, so this is in paise. Okay, so this part is called in paise and this whole part is in rupees. So if cost of 5 kg wheat flour is given, then we can easily able to find the cost of 1 kg of wheat by dividing the total cost by 5. So finally we will get the cost of 1 kg of wheat flour. So suppose if you want to buy 2 kg of wheat flour, okay, so if you want to buy 2 kg of wheat flour and you are given cost of 5 kg of wheat flour, then what we have to do? We have to first find the cost of 1 kg of wheat. Then only we can able to find the cost of 2 kg of wheat. Already I told you that if it is given for one object, then we can easily find for cost of many. So first of all, we have to find the cost of one item. Okay. And here we have to find the cost of 1 kg of wheat flour. So after finding this, we can easily able to find the cost of 2 kg of wheat flour by multiplying this amount with 2. Okay, so that will be our cost of 2 kg of wheat flour. So see here, the method we are using is unitary method. The meaning of unitary method is, here see one word is there, unit. The meaning of unit is 1. It may be one quantity, it may be 1 cm length, it may be 1 kg item, okay, but unit means 1. So first of all, we have to find for 1, then we can find for many using multiplication. So see here, cost of 1 kg item is this one, so you can easily divide and you will get this answer as this will be this much, okay, 7.30. So you can easily find the cost of 2 kg wheat flour by simply multiplying rupees 7.30 into 2. Already we have discussed this part in multiplication chapter, that if one cost of one item is given, then we can easily find for cost of many by multiplying the quantity with the cost. So finally we will get 14.60. This is the cost of 2 kg of wheat flour. Okay students, so this is called the unitary method. So in exercise 8.3 also, we are given cost of many items. Okay, so first of all we have to find the cost of one item, then we will able to answer all the question. We will able to find the cost of again 2 or 3 or 4 items. Okay, so let us start this exercise. So see, in exercise 8.3 question number 1, there are different objects given. You can see here there is an aeroplane model, and in which the their pieces are given. Okay, these are the pieces of the model air model airplane. Okay, so the first one is a wing. Okay, wing of the airplane. So 3 for rupees 16.50. That means we can buy this one, this wing, and this is 3. That is, cost of 3 wings will be rupees 16.50. So first of all, I have written the given condition. Given condition means which is given in the question. So cost of 3 wings of the airplane is given. That is rupees 16.50. So that means this is in rupees and this is in paise. Okay. So cost of one wing will be how much? Here we have to use the unitary method because we are finding for one. First of all, it was given for many, and secondly, we are finding for many one. Okay. So for one, you know that we have to divide. So we have to divide by 3. So that will be rupees 5.50. And this working you have to show in the in your copy, okay, in fair copy. So you are writing the question, so you are having space here also. Here also you can leave space in left side or right side, okay, any of the side you can leave the space, and you have to divide, you have to show the working. So how to do the how to divide, already we have discussed in the last lecture. So 16.50 you have to divide by 3. So like that you have to show the working. Okay, so this is 3 5s are, this will be 15. This is subtracted, decimal will go to this place in the quotient. So you have to take 5, then 3 5s are, this will be 15. Then again 0, so 3 zeros are 0. Okay, so remainder is 0. So you can see the cost of one wing will be rupees 5.50. So we can find the cost of 5 wings. So why I am finding the cost of 5 wings? So immediately below these figures you can see here, you have to find the cost of this much item. So the first one is wing. Okay, so wing is, how many wings are there, you have to count. So you can see 1 2 3 4 5, total 5 wings are there. That means we have to find the cost of 5 wings. Okay, so we already found the cost of one wing by just multiplying it with 5. We can easily able to find the cost of 5 wings, that will be rupees 27.50. So this multiplication already I have discussed, so I am not discussing it again. If you finding difficulty, you can ask me. Okay, so in next Zoom class you can ask your doubts. Okay, if you have any doubts you can ask me. So the next question is, cost of 2 screws are given, that is rupees 23. So we can easily find the cost of 1 screw by dividing 23 by 2. Okay, so see, you know already in fraction we have studied that 23 divided by 2 can be written as 23 by 2. So I am doing this question like this. Okay, but because you should know this step also. Okay, how to find using fraction also. Okay, so here like in previous question, I divided here, but I am not dividing here. I am just writing rupees 23 by 2. So see, we can divide 23 by 2, but we have to put the decimal point. We have to make it a decimal number, because see, this is an odd number and we are dividing an odd number by an even number. So this is not divisible, we know. So we have to put the decimal point after 23 for dividing. Okay, so I am not doing like in previous question I have done. First of all I have divided, then I have multiplied. So this question I am doing differently. So what is the difference? See, here I am not dividing it, just I am writing 23 by 2. So what is the next step? See, therefore cost of 8 screws. So we know that already we found cost of 1 screw is 23 by 2. So what will be the cost of 8 screw? Yes, we have to multiply 8 with this number. So this is a fraction, no problem, this is a fraction. Okay, we will write this fraction as it is and we will multiply it with 8. So we know that if we are multiplying with 8, so we can write it as 8 by 1. Already we have done in fraction. So here I am applying that fraction properties here. Okay, so keep this thing in mind. Just see whichever topics we have discussed earlier, we have to apply it in questions. Okay, so by that way you can remember the topics also. Okay, so here you can see we have to check that is there any cancellation is happening. We have to check. So see, here it is 2, here in numerator it is 8. So we know that we can cancel numerator and denominator. So 2 and 8, we can cancel it out. So see, we can use the multiplication table of 2. So 2 ones are, okay, 2 fours are 8. So see, in denominator we will get 1 into 1, that will be 1, and in numerator we will get 23 into 4. So this will be 4 threes are 12, 1 will be carry over, that means 9, 4 twos are 8 plus 1 9. So rupees 92 is the cost of 8 screw. So students, please try to do the question like this only, okay. Don't use one method only. You have to remember the things which you have learned earlier. Okay. So by that way, you will able to remember the previous topics also. Okay. So see, next I am giving you the homework that gum, cost of 3 gum is given and second is cost of 1 K is given, that is rupees 12. So I am giving you as a homework. Then the last one is rod. Okay, so cost of 5 rods are given, rupees 76.25. So we can easily find the cost of 1 rod, that will be rupees 76.25 divided by 5. So see, I have done the working here. So we have to do the division process. We have to show it. Okay, you have to show this process. So divide this decimal number by 5. By this way, you will get rupees 15.25. Okay. So what will be the cost of 8 rods then? It will be, this cost will be multiplied with 8. So by that way we will get rupees 122. Okay. So student, next question is question number 2. So here 3 boxes are given first of all. So below 2 boxes are the bills. Okay. This is the first bill. This is the second bill you have to make. So in the first box it is given all the conditions, all the cost of the items. Okay, so in the first one, the cost of 3 toothpaste, okay, quantity is given 3. Okay, so cost of 3 toothpaste is given rupees 85.50. similarly, cost of 4 soap is given 60 rupees. Cost of 8 kg rice is given 202 rupees. Cost of 10 kg wheat flour is given rupees 185. Cost of 2 kg washing powder is given rupees 86. Similarly, cost of 6 packets of biscuit is given rupees 74.50. Cost of 10 pieces of buns is given rupees 42. And the total price is given, that is 731 rupees. Okay. So now we have to make this bill, that is first bill and second bill. So in first bill, the quantity is 2 for the toothpaste. So first of all, we have to find the cost of 2 toothpaste. So in the original bill, okay, the cost of 3 toothpaste is given. Okay, the given condition is 3 toothpaste. The cost of 3 toothpaste is given. So from that information, we have to first find the cost of 1 toothpaste using unitary method. Then we can easily able to find the cost of 2 toothpaste. Okay, so I am doing bill 1 and bill 2. You have to do it. You have to find the total amount. Okay. So see, cost of 3 toothpaste is rupees 85.50. This I have written from the first information which was given in the first box. Okay. So using that, cost of 1 toothpaste we can easily find. We have to divide by 3. Therefore, cost of 2 toothpaste will be multiplied by 2. That will be rupees 57.00. So here we have to write price. Just write here in rupees. So no need to write rupees here again. So we can directly write 57.00. Similarly, rice. Okay, what is the cost of rice is given in information in first box. You can see the cost of 8 kg rice is given. Okay, so we can write that one. So students, see, next is the cost of 8 kg of rice is given. I have written this information from the first box. Okay, first table. So from here we can easily find the cost of 1 kg of rice. That will be rupees 202 divided by 8. Okay. Next, for finding the cost of 4 kg rice, for finding the cost of 5 kg rice, because in bill 1 we have to find the cost of 5 kg rice. So first of all, using unitary method, we found cost of 1 kg rice this much, and cost of 5 kg rice will be into 5. So after multiplication and after dividing it by 8, finally I got what? Rupees 126.25. So that calculation you have to do it by yourself, and you have to show the working process and in the rough, okay, inside. Next is cost of wheat flour. We have to find the cost of 5 kg wheat flour. Already we found it cost of the toothpaste, okay, toothpaste, cost of 5 kg rice. Now cost of wheat flour. So here you can see cost of 10 kg wheat flour is given from the first information. From the information which was given in first table, the cost of 10 kg wheat flour is this one. So unitary, using unitary method, the cost of 1 kg wheat flour will be rupees 185 by 10. Therefore, cost of 5 kg wheat flour will be this much multiplied with 5. That will be rupees 92.5. We can write 92.50 also. Okay. So this much is the cost of the cost of 5 kg wheat flour. Next is biscuits. So so from the first information, you can see the cost of 6 packets biscuit is given. Cost of 6 packets biscuit was rupees 70. So from that information, we have to find the cost of 1 packet biscuit. Okay. See, next information I have written. So cost of 6 packets biscuit was given rupees 70.50. So cost of 1 packet biscuit will be this one. So cost of 3 packets biscuit will be rupees 70.50 divided by 6 into 3. So next you can cancel it out. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So by dividing 70.50 by 2, you will get rupees, this will be 35.25. Okay. So this is 35.25. This is the cost of 3 packets of biscuit. So next, what we have to do in the bill? Already we have found the cost of every item. Okay, that is cost of toothpaste was 2 toothpaste was this one, this much. Then cost of 5 kg rice was this much. So like that, all the cost we have already found. Now we have to add all the price. So after adding all the price, see how to add. We know already we have done in the last chapter, that is in decimals, we have done how to add the decimal number. So we can add this. Okay, this will be, see, 0 plus 5 plus 0 plus 5 will be 10. 1 will be carry over. So this will be 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 2, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. So 0. So after that we have to put the decimal point, and here it is. After adding we got 10, so 0 and 1 will be carry over. So 7 plus 1 will be 8, 8 plus 6 will be 14, plus 2 16, 16 plus 5 21. So 1 carrying 2. So 5 plus 2 7, 7 plus 2 9, 9 plus 9 18, 18 plus 3 21. So again 1. 2 will be carry over, so 2 plus 1 is 3. So the total the cost, that is the total bill, is of how much rupees? This is of rupees 311. So students, similarly you have to do, you have to make the second bill also using the information which was given in the first table. Okay students, so thank you for today.